folks. Tonight we have Mount Lebanon against Altoona here tonight. And I'm Matt Babich. Alongside with me, my new partner up here, Colin Whitty.
Hello,
and this is the final game to our tip-off tournament.
Yeah, you know, Mount Lebanon comes in off a hot, 40-point win yesterday against... class that they have coming in for the 2019 season.
Yeah, overall, really great performance by Mount Lebanon last night. Played excellent on defense, picked right back where they left off last year, running their press, and that whole scheme of running double teams. Really didn't rely too much on the three last night as they did for predominantly last year, but really played well in the paint. Like, they were able to get in and move around on the with inside the three-point line. So, very interesting start for Mount Lebanon as they're 1-0, as long Altoona is as well. So Mount Lebanon would like the push to be 2-0, as I'm sure Altoona is. And earlier, before this evening, we had the losers' consolation game as Obama Academy played against Montour, as Montour won that, moving on to 1-1, and Obama Academy falls to 0-2. Tough start to begin this season for them. Last night, Montour lost to Altoona, and as Colin mentioned before, it was a close loss. They only beat them by 1 point, and the ending was very controversial also with the officiating and the amount of time remaining on the clock. And then Mount Lebanon played all around really well last night as they had a win that went into the double digits. And that's all for now, and the national anthem will be underway, and we'll be taking care of lineups from then on.
Just to interrupt you for a sec, I was just watching Altoona warm up real quick, putting up shots. I did not see a lot of misses, so this Altoona team, very experienced team, a lot of seniors and juniors on this team. Looks like they could shoot as we begin the national anthem here, and then we'll get into the starting lineups. We'll see you next. Starting lineup. Number 11, KJ Luttrell. Number 4, Philippe Pierce. Number 22, Jeremiah Crockett. Number 2, Tyler Becker. number 33, Nate Corleaders, and Mount Lebanon coming up.
And now for Mount Lebanon, for starting for us, we have junior number 24, Jake Ranke. And senior number 15, Joey King. Number 31, Andy Sapp, senior. And the senior, number 33, Jake Hoffman. And finally, senior number 11, Blaine Gartley. And Mount Lebanon is coached by none other than Coach Joe David. And tip-off is just shortly here, as we have a good one. And as we mentioned before, both these teams are undefeated heading into this one. So, a lot at stake for both these teams. Was a chance to either go.
Look for Mount Lebanon to get off to their hot start, as they do, as they're known for in the Joey David basketball era. The annual zone press defense gave a lot of offenses trouble, and it sure gave Obama Academy troubles yesterday. So look for Mount Lebanon to get that early and often with all their guards and playmakers up front.
All right, and tip-off is now just underway, as it looks like for Altoona. They do not have a fifth player on the floor right now. Their fifth player looks to be getting his shoes tied or something of that.
Way to start out a game, huh?
Yeah, honestly.
Four players. As he makes his entrance, number four will take the tip off.
And number 33, Hoffman from Mount Lebanon, will be.
Weird formation from Altoona here. As they go in the corners here as they pinch down. Tip goes to Gartley. Gives it to the senior Hoffman. Back to Gartley, little zone here. 2-3 zone following Sapp. Gives it back to Sapp. Back to Hoffman. Looks like they're playing a 2-2 zone and one on man. Back to Gartley. He'll hoist a three. No good. Rebound King. He'll go back upward. No good on the lay-in. Back out to Hoffman. Hoffman penetrates, back out to Gartley. Gartley, Ranke, and it's tipped out of bounds. Mount Lebanon will retain possession. Now what you're seeing here, folks, you may be confused a little bit, is it looks like you're seeing a 2-3 zone from Altoona, but they're going on against Andy Sapp, the senior guard. Now they're just in the annual 2-3 zone as Hoffman will hoist a three. And it's good. Jake Hoffman, the senior, had a big game yesterday. Looks to continue to do that here against Altoona with that three-pointer. So you see the annual press, and it caused a turnover. Gartley with the steal, pass to Hoffman in transition. Now back to Gartley. Ranke from the corner, he'll hoist a three, no good. Rebound King, and he'll get fouled on the play as Mount Lebanon will take the ball under the basket. Good start from Mount Lebanon so far.
Yeah, obviously, as we just saw here on Altoona's first possession here, they were able to take it to looked at the half-court line, but then found themselves getting real stumbled, and Blaine Gartley was there for the steal. So, and he launches a three now, and that clanks off the rim. Ranke showing his physicality there, getting the rebound, and Hoffman, that one bounces around there a little bit on the backboard and the rim, and that three-point attempt. And Gartley, he makes the extra pass. Mount Lebanon moving around. Hoffman, he drives it. Great play there. Mount Lebanon up 5-0.
Mount Lebanon getting a lot of second chances with their rebounds here. Jake Hoffman, Jake Ranke with a lot of rebounds, giving the Blue Devils an extra chance.
Yeah, along with the ability to make the extra pass too. Have not been in a shoot first. They're usually just swinging around, trying to find which shot works best for them. And Sapp, he pulls up, and he lets it go for three. As Mount Lebanon is now up by six, as they are on the board, 8-2. Altoona took a little bit of time there to get it inbounded, and risky pass there. 22 now. He drives in. Takes a nice, easy shot right off the corner of the glass. Very good fundamental play by them there. 8-4 now. Hoffman. He unloads for a deep three, and that one bounces around a bit. And it looks like it's going to be Altoona possession there, as they're going to call a foul on number 15, Joey King. He gets his first personal, and that's a foul pretty early on. Last night, he played really well overall, but got into some foul trouble there.
Mount Lebanon goes into their annual 2-1-2 defense with Jake Hoffman anchoring the middle. And you're going to see a lot of that tonight. Sloppy play from Altoona leads to three layups. No good from Ranky there. Gets to inside King. He'll hoist a floater. No good. Rebound number 22. As Altoona will slow up. Here comes a trap. Goes by the trap. Little Euro step. No good on the lay-in. Mount Lebanon will try a race here to get another basket here. Gartley to Senior. Passes it to Ranky. To Sapp. Sapp goes baseline. Not got quite fouled there, but it ends up in Mount Lebanon's favor as Joey King gets the lay-in. And Altoona will take a timeout. Mount Lebanon, good defense, leads to good offense here for the Blue Devils as they're off to a good start. 10-4 here early. 3 minutes into the game.
Yeah, an excellent job there by Joey King after his teammate got blocked, but really did a good job of helping clean up that play and just getting the bucket to go right in for the layup. Once again, showing off Mount Lebanon's paint presence. Both teams will be returned to the floor as coaches review over some of their final plans after a timeout called by Altoona. For those of you just tuning in, we have 5:02 remaining in the first quarter as Mount Lebanon leads 10-4, up by 6, and fairly close one to begin here. Altoona's possession, 33 receives the inbound, gets it back to 2. 2 over to head past 11. 11 stops for a second. Altoona finally gets their cross half court. 22 now in triple threat position. Dribbles past a couple Mount Lebanon defenders. Stops. Kicks it. Number 4. Nice shot in the corner. No good. And nice hustle play there by number 2. He goes in. Gets the as well.
Really good segment there from Altoona. Obviously, the one way to beat the zone is to move quick passes. They got a cutting 33 in the middle, which led to the open 3. And now a foul shot. And one play for number 2. It ends up short here.
And Gartley now, he pushes the tempo for Mount Lebanon. He drives in, kicks it to Hoffman. Hoffman, he puts a nice move there on his defender. Sapp wide open for 3. Too much space they gave him there, but excellent play by Hoffman to go clean up that play and get the rebound. And a missed attempt there by Gartley. Hoffman tips it, but number 2, he ends up getting the rebound, but Mount Lebanon with another steal. And wow. Hoffman did a spin move there as he almost gets the layup to fall in, but no good, and an Altoona player tipped it out there. And Mount Lebanon will also be retaining possession now. And it looked like number 10 for Altoona there was going to make a sub, but the ref said otherwise. Maybe someone with a jersey or a shirt. Who knows? Yeah, undershirt. And now Hoffman looked like he had the chance there to shoot it. Gartley, he moves in. He drives in. Kicks it to King. And wow, what a move by King.
Great pass by the senior Blaine there to get it to the open Joey King for the and one. And looking for a three-point play here.
King does a great job there of drawing that foul. And now he'll be on to the free throw line. In these first two games, this game let alone, he has really been establishing himself as a force and really did a good job of that yesterday, too, down in the paint. Look forward to seeing that the rest of this season from him. And no good on the free throw there as Altoona tips it, gets the rebound. Now they have possession of the ball. 11. He kicks to 4. 4. Loses dribble there. And look who's there. Joey Kent. Now Stapp, he lets it go into corner. And that just bounces off the rim. And it looks like they're going to call a foul on the play there. It looks like it might be on...
Break of 4.5 minutes here. The one thing I'm observing a lot is Mount Lebanon's had a lot of time possession here. Either Altoona's a little nervous, a lot of turnovers, but Mount Lebanon getting second chances with those offensive rebounds leading to second chance points.
And King now has his second as he's in a little bit of foul trouble here. As we have about 3.5 to go in the first quarter, he already has two, but still, just got to watch what he's doing on defense, that's all. Mount Lebanon now moves it around as a little bit of over the head passes here and there. We'll try and look for the open man. Ranky, he hesitates, triple threat position. Gartley way over the head, even across the court too. Risky pass there, but he still gets it. Hoffman, he drives in, kicks it to Sapp. Sapp, he's open for three, and that one rolls out again for him. Altoona now has 11. He puts a move on this Hoffman there. He kicks it to 22. 22, he looks around. Attempts to put a spin move. Kicks it to 10. 10, drives. Thinks about taking the layup. Turns around. He gets the bucket to go in.
Good fadeaway there.
12-2 as Mount Lebanon.
Risky
nearly
pass there from Blaine Garvey. Mount Lebanon faithful. but Gartley picks up his first. Mount Lebanon team foul number 4. Hoffman comes a trap, goes to the middle. Good play. That's a great play by Jake Ranke, the junior there. Saw that the cutting 10 was going in, read the play very well, tips it out of bounds, keep Mount Lebanon alive for this possession. Back to 22, look for a corner for number 2. He could light it up. We saw that yesterday against Montour. Pass it to Lebanon. I think they want one shot. A little push off there. No. Number 10, number 22 now. 11, he'll drive baseline, put up a little floater, no good. Rebound back to 11. He'll put up the layup, and it goes at the buzzer.
Wow.
Altoona, they struggled early on, but hey, they're back in it. It's a 5-point game, 17-12 at the end of the first quarter.
And overall, it's been really close. These two teams have really been going back and forth, and I think Altoona's really done a good job being able to take advantage of Mount Lebanon, attempting the threes, but really not being able to find the bottom of the net tonight. I mean, last night they didn't shoot too much from three, but it's clear tonight they're trying to change that scheme up and do otherwise, but they've only hit a few, so.
It's hard to play a 2-3 zone against a team like Mount Lebanon, obviously. If you know they can light it up from three-pointer. Did start off with the way they wanted to, but looks like they're going to get going here, as maybe the layup and the three-pointer from Hoffman will get them going here to make some three-pointers down the road.
Yeah, and to go along with that, like what you said about the 2-3 zone against a team that likes to shoot like Mount Lebanon, another thing they also like to do is move the ball around. Like, they really do try to find the open shot so they can get that three-pointer. So they got to be aware of that. It's not going to be one of those two passes and then shoot from Mount Lebanon. They're really going to pass it around. They're going to make it close to 10 passes per possession they have. So
usually the decrease in the 2-3 zone is a three-pointer, but that's been working out in Altoona's favor. Mount Lebanon did not shoot the ball well in the first quarter, but usually the advantage in the 2-3 zone is rebounding, but it looks like it's a little opposite tonight. Altoona's clearly getting out-rebound, out-hustled by the Blue Devils. Number 44, Tommy Peters, and number 24, Jake Ranke, a big part of that. Getting plays, leading them to second possessions for the Blue Devils, leading the points.
Right, and we're in here for the second quarter now. As Altoona has possession, and number 10 found on an island there, but didn't turn around and take the layup. Number 2 takes the 3. As that does a little bouncing around on the rim there. It seemed like it would be in and out, but Mount Lebanon possession now. They have their first possession in the second quarter. And Gartley, he pushed the tempo for Mount Lebanon. Mount Lebanon moving it around. And like we were saying in between, they already have at least half a dozen passes here. And honestly, with that 2-3 defense, you got to be ready, because with all that passing, you don't know when they're going to shoot it. They really make it questionable with all the pump fakes, and then next thing you know, they're throwing it over their heads to somebody. So Gartley, he's now calling out a play now, as he's trying to get what looks like Peters to move. Kicks to Peters, back to Gartley. Oh, he looks like he dropped that there for a second. And great backdoor pass by Sapp there. Gartley, he fakes the pass. Hoffman, he drives in, over the head. And Mount Lebanon looks like they could have got a shot off there, and now here comes
the ball movement.
Hoffman, that's being tipped up in the air. Ranke saves the day. Now Gartley, he shoots, that hits off the front of the rim. There by Hoffman. Not much he really could have done there though. 11, he pulls up, fade away, no good. Ball's tipped up there. 22, he saves it for Altoona. They're going to give him a traveling call. Interesting call there. He appears to be frustrated about that. And honestly, it kind of did look like he was just dribbling. I didn't see the feet move there too much. An excellent pass there by Sapp as he feeds. He was going to feed Peters down low, but they're going to call a hell ball. And it looks like Mount Lebanon will retain possession. About a minute and a half in, still no bucket scored yet. And never mind that.
Play call by Jerry David. Get the two decoys over there, Sapp and Peters there. And Jake Hoffman screaming down the lane for the easy layup. Mount Lebanon leads by 7 here.
And Mount Lebanon running a track. a zone there. And an excellent pass there is number
great
four.
Pass.
He muscles that one up in there to get the layup for Altoona. 19-14. And looks like miscommunication there on who the target for that pass was. Ranky looked like he had the opportunity to shoot. Now he is wide open for three. Takes it. Oh, and that one rolls right out. Garley, he takes a three. There you go. Nothing but net by him. Maybe catching his shot now. Getting the shot to fall. So.
Need him for confidence as well. Mount Lebanon playing very aggressive here on defense, trying to get a steal. 11 drives in, low layup. No good. Rebound Ranky. As number 22 deflects it. Mount Lebanon gain possession here.
Good hustle play by number 22 there. Really just had to think quickly there. Just turns around, tips it out. So not much more you can ask out of him there.
Here's a 1-2-2 defense for Altoona here. Trying to get it to the corner and trap immediately. The weakness for the 1-2-2, look for the middle. Big Tommy Peters there. As passing, we'll get the Blue Devils safe over the line here. Gartley will drive in. Hoffman, he'll hoist a three. No good. Rebound Peters. Looks like he's fouled there from number 10 there. Tommy Peters, great hustle play. And the Blue Devils get foul called on number 10. And the Blue Devils will get it underneath the basket here. Coming in now, number 22, the sophomore, Zach D'Alessandro, coming in for the Red Hot. Jake Rank here has gotten off to a great start here. D'Alessandro, number 22, the sophomore. He'll get the ball.
Oh,
he'll
wow.
hoist a three. Wide open. Short on the three. 22 gets the rebound and passes it back. Mount Lebanon in white. Altoona in maroon. It's a missed layup. Number four looks like he hurt his ankle there, trying to play through it.
Yeah, it looked like he rushed that one.
Corner here. D'Alessandro drives in. Stolen
almost.
Here. And
yeah.
Foul will be called here by either number 10 or number 11. Hacking D'Alessandro. Yep, number 10. Two quick fouls from number 10 here in a span of 30 seconds.
Yeah, Altoona. Mount Lebanon didn't have anybody in with the jersey number 10, so a little bit of a miscommunication there. Looks like Coach Joe David shouting out some inbound plays for Mount Lebanon to run as Altoona brings in the sub now.
Look for the streaking Jake Hoffman here. Obviously, Mount Lebanon got him last play, so look for him to go in here. It'll be out to Peters, back to Gartley. Ball movement here, key for Mount Lebanon here as Gartley will drive in, look for Hoffman. Sap will go baseline. Looking for D'Alessandro, gives it to him. Back to Gartley. Gartley drives in. Good feed to Peters. Peters with
wow.
the lay-in. Great feed from Blaine Gartley there. Mount Lebanon takes a 10-point lead here. Just under 4 minutes to go in the second quarter.
That was a great play there. It was awesome play by or pass by Gartley, but it looked like it was a little low. But great job there by Peters to be able to catch that and get the crucial basket. Deep three there, that was no good.
Hoffman in the corner, goes baseline. Gartley with the pass fake. Hoffman, he'll go to the middle, and a foul called on number two. Altoona, only two more fouls away until Mount Lebanon gets into the bonus. And as you may know, Mount Lebanon can really knock it down from the free throw line. Key points here in a critical game to decide the championship in the Mount Lebanon tournament.
Yeah, Altoona really has to watch what they're doing here on defense. Overall, they've been doing really good, but those two fouls, Mount Lebanon has a lot of shooters, and if they give them the chance to shoot the free throws here, that might not be a good look for Altoona, and they might be digging themselves into an even deeper hole here on the scoreboard.
D'Alessandro misses from three there. As Ranky comes in for Gartley, Gartley takes a seat. Ranky, immediate impact, rebound there. As Ranky has a clear lane here, he'll get the screen from Peters. Gives it to Hoffman. Sapp goes baseline. Alessandro in the corner to try for another three. No good.
Oh,
rebound,
wow.
Hoffman. Long wingspan there. Back to Reinke. He'll hoist the three. He'll got it.
There you go.
Jake Reinke. 4-3. Big three by the junior there, Jake Reinke. And Altoona is forced to take another timeout. Great defense leads to great offense. Rebounds leads to secondary points, and that's what the Blue Devils are doing. That's why they have a 13-point lead here, 2:46 to go in the second quarter.
Exactly, and what you just said, Colin, Mount Lebanon has been doing an excellent job of executing that. And if you just saw right now on the screen, Mount Lebanon just did exactly that with Hoffman going in. Missed the layup there, but still didn't give up on the play. Goes up and gets the rebound, finds his teammate wide open. Hits a three, puts him up by double digits, so.
Teach skill, but you cannot teach hustle, in my opinion. Obviously, Mount Lebanon has a great coaching staff. They're teaching hustle, and it's worked out in their favor as they've gotten many offensive rebounds, leading to secondary chances, and they've capitalized on that, obviously, with a 13-point lead for versus Altoona. It's a little 2-1-2 zone here. Hoffman anchoring the middle, trying to 33 will go to the middle. He'll stop, gets it to two. He'll get back to 33 as Mount Lebanon goes back into man. Alessandro on number two, gives it to 11. Gartley coming out to guard him, forcing him left. Not giving up the right. Screen from 22. 11 will go by him. Little lay-in, no good. Rebound 22.
Great hustle there. Looked like 11 almost had that layup in, but it just kind of rolled around on the rim there. That's tough for Altoona. Those ones really hurt, especially when it looks like it's about to go in.
Two will race to three. No good. Rebound, Gartley. He'll drive in. Foul called on number two. As he was a bump and run here for Brian Gartley. Good job by him selling the foul. A blocking foul will be on number two. That's number two's second. Team foul number six. One more and they're in the bonus one-on-one here. Mount Lebanon will call an inbounds play here. Gartley will come around in the corner. He'll get it. This will go into their open offense, pass and cut here. Gartley will get a screen from Hoffman, going baseline back to Hoffman. Hoffman will hoist the three. And
oh, wow.
Off the rim and in for Jake Hoffman. And a 16-point lead here. And this is exactly what Mount Lebanon wants to do, trap you. Make the tough passes here. It's number 33. He'll have that stolen by D'Alessandro. Back to Hoffman. And number 11 with a costly foul here. As you know, Jake Hoffman is lights out from the free throw line. He'll be going there for a 1-on-1. 1:25 left. Mount Lebanon with a 16-point lead here in the second quarter.
Yeah, you brought up a really good point there about Mount Lebanon with the excellent closeout, his ability to get stops. And they've only allowed Altoona to get one basket here this quarter. Coming into the second, it was 17-12, and now here we are, 30-14. So. And Hoffman, he'll be shooting two now from Mount Lebanon. Takes the first. It'll be one of one, and he gets that one to go. 31-14, Mount Lebanon up 15. And that's a very commanding lead at this point in the game, heading into this quarter. It's a pretty close one, as they only led by five.
Last night.
Yeah. Altoona's definitely giving Mount Lebanon a bit of a challenge here, as really did a good job of keeping it close in the first quarter and even entering into this quarter. Wasn't too much action within that first two-minute period, so. But now Mount Lebanon up by nearly 20 is Altoona. They bring the ball in. About a minute and a half to go, number four. He takes some contact there from Gartley, and they're likely going to call the foul on him. And, yes, they do. And that'll be his second personal, and that gives Mount Lebanon their fifth team foul, and they're two away from putting Altoona in the bonus. And for Mount Lebanon, number four, Mikey Puffer enters the game.
Mikey Puffer, the freshman, can give Coach Joe David great minutes off the bench. Obviously, he's a freshman, but good defender, and can shoot the ball from 3-2 against the 2-3 zone.
Yeah, really did an excellent job of showcasing that last night. Played for the remaining minutes of the fourth quarter, but he showed that he's not afraid to shoot the ball, was able to put the ball in the net, and even he was even able to facilitate the ball really well, giving some assists and throwing it, slinging it all around the court, making his teammates better. So definitely something to look out for the with Mount Lebanon Hoops within these next coming years as his game develops.
Coach David just sent through his team one shot here as we get the 43-second mark here in the second quarter. Mount Lebo doubling Altoona's lead as Coach David will take the veteran move here and take the timeout, 30-second timeout, maybe draw up a play here for their playmaker, Jake Hoffman.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head there. He really has been their playmaker tonight. He's been going in, making the dirty plays down low, getting the rebound, doing all the dirty work. So he's been getting assists, kicking it out to his teammates who are out near the three-point line, maybe even a little bit inside, generating offense off that. And even himself, he's been taking a couple threes here and there tonight as he's looked okay from there as well. So he's been able to put the ball in the basket as well.
Smart play by the veteran coach, Joe David, substituting back in Joey King and Blaine Gartley as Mount Lebanon has their starting five here. Obviously, Blaine Gartley and Joey King are both dealing with foul trouble, but since they're on offense, Coach Joe David will run the cards here and hope that you not get a charge here, give up a good shot here so that you can hit their playmakers in for the remaining 35 seconds here. Yeah. Mount Lebanon leading 32-16.
And that's a smart move by Blaine King because he's really done within these first two games, really showing off his aggression. If Mount Lebanon wants to get a shot here before the final couple seconds and say they were to miss, he's really somebody they can trust down low to go down there and get the rebound. So
Mount Lebanon passing it around here, trying the waste clock. 11 ticks to go here as Hoffman looks like he'll take the final shot. Actually gets it to Gartley, looking for the back screen to Hoffman. Sapp, Ranky with a great look in the corner. No good, rebound Hoffman. And a foul called. Jake Hoffman with the foul called. Obviously the second chance points there for Hoffman. He was right there, ball bounced right to him, able to get the shot off at the half. Great play by Jake Hoffman. He'll shoot two here, likely to end the half. Mount Lebanon leading 32-16 in their tournament to open up the year.
And they're going to put 0.3 seconds back on the clock now, as likely once these free throws are done, it'll just be Altoona is just going to have to really tip or just heave it in from half court. But Mount Lebanon really keeping all their guys back near the half court line, just trying to prevent something from crossing half court.
You rarely see that from the all-Whitfield first team player, Jake Hoffman, missed foul shot. Here comes his second. It's good. Now we'll likely wrap up this half as the clock will wind down. No good, and Mount Lebanon will take a commanding 33-16 lead. Obviously, Mount Lebanon did play their best half, didn't shoot the ball very well, but hey, second chance points has been saying a lot, but it's all true. Second chance points lead you to game winners, and Mount Lebanon playing their heart out, playing a lot more aggressive and outplaying Altoona at this point.
Exactly. And we'll be back with you just shortly as the final minutes of halftime remain, just to give you a little bit more coverage about the game and what to expect possibly in the second half. folks. If you were just tuning in, it's halftime's wrapping up right now as Mount Lebanon is up 33-16 against Altoona. I'm Matt Babich. Alongside with me, I have Colin Witte. And we're witnessing a pretty good game here as Mount Lebanon does have a little bit of a challenge tonight in their tip-off tournament that Obama Academy kind of struggled against them last night. But Altoona seems, as they are only down by 15, but they do seem to kind of have Mount Lebanon's number a little bit more here tonight. So,
yeah, you could say that a lot. And Mount Lebanon, you could say Mount Lebanon did play their best first half. And Mount Lebanon only shooting 26% from three-pointer, 6 of 23, so definitely struggling from them. Obviously getting a lot of three-pointers because of Altoona's 2-3 zone. Altoona, the thing that kills them is definitely 6 turnovers from Altoona. Can't do that against Mount Lebanon. Obviously, Joe David is known for the zone press, which has caused a lot of turnovers over the years for multiple teams. Second chance points have been a lot. Mount Lebanon with 8 second chance points and 15 offensive rebounds. I mean, usually that's pretty good. Usually the strength of the 2-3 zone is getting easy rebounds. Not tonight. These Mount Lebanon Blue Devils, including Jake Reinke, Tommy Peters, and Jake Hoffman, has all done a great job getting these rebounds, getting second chance points for the Blue Devils here. As they, Altoona and Mount Lebanon both take the court here. Just under a minute to go before we start the second half as the horn buzzes. And it should be a fun second half. Mount Lebanon should hold on here.
Yep.
But just in a couple of minutes, Altoona could come back in this game. Mount Lebanon, obviously, they play their best first half. They're trying to improve the second half, improve every game here, win the third quarter, and they should be good to win this game and the tip-off tournament.
And the stat that you brought up that really interests me the most is Altoona with only 6 turnovers. That's not too bad. Coming into an atmosphere.
Compared to Obama Academy,
yeah.
That's not too bad.
Coming into an atmosphere like Mount Lebanon where the crowd really takes basketball seriously, they get into it. You have a lot of the crowd, the student section. And Mount Lebanon, as you mentioned, playing in this atmosphere with a really good defense that's running press, double teams at you, having that limit on a turnover is not too bad for the first half.
Yeah.
Maybe they can look to continue that in the second here, maybe spark a little bit of a comeback as they're not being completely blown out right now. They still do have a shot as they are down by less than 20. So we'll find out here as the beginning of the second half is just underway now. Nice dish to 4 there. Takes the 3. Looks like he's a little bit off. And Hoffman gets the rebound from Mount Lebanon. Gartley almost runs out of bounds around the sideline. Kicks the sap. Gartley wide open for 3. That hits off the front of the rim. Tough break there. And 11 almost put a move, but loses his dribble in the process. Luckily saves it.
Risky
and
pass.
Passes it away. Yeah, very risky pass there. He drives in. Makes a nice move. Strong attempt, but no good. And look who's under there, Joey King, scooping up another rebound. Him and Hoffman have really done a good job of facilitating down low as they've really been making some physical and getting done the dirty work for Mount Lebanon as they're getting the tough rebound. So,
great play call there,
yeah,
from Joe David. Fake to swing pass to Andy Sapp. You got a streaking Jake Hoffman going backdoor. Quick, easy 2 points for the Blue Devils.
Yeah, awesome backdoor there by Hoffman. As he took a couple fadeaways from deep in the beginning, but seems to be finding his mark here tonight as it's 35-19.
From what we saw from yesterday's game from Montoros, Hoffman takes the floater, no good. Number 2 can really, really shoot the ball.
Yeah.
They were down like 7 or 8, and he hit 2 threes, got them right back into the game, leading to the Montour win by 1 yesterday. So number 2 can get going and shoot some threes here. Altoona can get back in this game, boost his confidence up a little bit.
And an excellent play there by King as he got in there against number 2 and just, they hit the floor, but he went in there, made sure he got the ball, and Mount Lebanon was possession. And a great layup there.
Great pass by number two, reading him for the layup. Zone here, reading back in the man. Looks like they're playing man here. As Reiki with another offensive rebound here. Zap, he'll hoist the three. No good. Rebound. Reiki comes in and gets the jump ball. Jake Reiki doing all the dirty work here for the Blue Devils as they are not shooting the ball particularly well. But hey, second chance points leads to open shots and Mount Lebanon sooner than later. Start hitting these shots, but great job by the junior, Jake Reiki.
Yeah, exactly, and really getting in there and showing off some physicality, making their presence known.
Mount Lebanon goes into the zone, back to man here. That is a high zone here, 1-2-2, back in the man. Man here from Mount Lebanon, a pick and roll, four of them receives it. Looked like he might have traveled there, got away with it. Two, whole horse to three, no good, off the boards. Hoffman, good play by number 11 there. Hoffman recovers here, pass to Reiki. Reiki with the and one. Jake Reiki, the junior, making his presence felt often. And he'll go to the line for a chance for a three-point play here as Mount Lebanon leads Altoona 37-21, 5:24 left in the third quarter.
Excellent play there by him. He ran perfectly, ran right to the hoop with the ball, and he took it right up and showed his physicality. Is on that foul, it looked like he kind of got like hit in the face there and just was able to play through it. Props to him. And he hits that free throw now from Mount Lebanon, as there looks to be a little confusion for Altoona, but 22 inbounds. He finds 11, immediately guarded by Sapp. Sapp all over the place for Mount Lebanon's defense now. Number 10, he looks behind. That's the throw behind him, and Gurley, he
great
interferes with it. Great hustle there to interfere with that. Still, Altoona remains with possession. And
look for the trap here. Jake Reiki going the back. Andy Sapp trying to anchor the middle. There he goes. There goes Reiki. As Gartley got hit there, no foul called on the play. Reiki on an island with number 11. Sapp comes over to help him. 11, dribble moves, he'll drive in. Stripped by Sapp, he retains possession. Number 4 in the corner, he'll go. Blocked by Hoffman! Hoffman with the block. He's coming with a full head of steam, pass to Sapp. Sapp for the lay-in, it's good. Andy Sapp with four quick points here for the Blue Devils early in the second half. As the trap comes here, Sapp and Reiki, 33 in the middle. Tough time corralling that ball. Then gets it to 22. Trapped in the corners is exactly what Mount Lebanon wants you to do. He somehow gets out of it. Pass to 11, the point guard. He'll step back. Go up to number 33. Streaking 10. And a foul will be called.
A
travel called on number 10. Looks like he might have fouled there, but ref goes with the travel. Mount Lebanon retains possession as Altoona will go into their full court press here.
Yeah, number 10 was shaken up there. His first couple steps getting up had a little bit of a limp, but. And we see Altoona now running press, trying to emulate Mount Lebanon's game a little bit in hopes to create some turnovers. But Obama Academy tried that last night. It didn't work too well for them, as Mount Lebanon really had that idea read. And Mount Lebanon really does do pretty well against teams that run press. I'd say the only other team in their division that does is Baldwin, and they were able to figure that out really quick. And when they were pressing, they had
good
Baldwin
pass
stumbling there.
Jake Reiki is playing outstanding basketball tonight. Great pass to the open Joey King, who we said a lot, done the dirty work. There he's rewarded with a 5 feet floater there to give Mount Lebanon a 21-point lead here. As Altoona faithful does not agree with that call, Hoffman will go to the line for the deuce.
Yeah, that looked like one of those that could really go either way. So it looked like it could have been a charge, but at the same time, it could have been a blocking foul. From here, we couldn't really tell if his feet were moving. If that was the case, blocking foul. But if he stood still, charge, and Altoona would have possession. So first. And Altoona with some substitutions now is number 2 and number 5.
I don't think we've seen number 5 tonight. We have seen number 2. He just hit a 3. But not number 5, so we'll see what he has for Altoona here.
Yeah, it should be interesting. And nothing but net on the second attempt there. And now we have Peters, number 44. He checks in for Lebo. And the ref signals for the ball to come in. And Altoona.
2-2-1 here. Trying to guard the middle.
Yeah, and down in the paint, Peters guards that area. 11 of Altoona, he drives in, and wow, what a move there. Is he?
Great take.
Yeah, swung that ball around there, as what some people call the jelly move, and
jelly.
He got that in, yeah.
Jelly.
He'll be going to free throw line to shoot one, too. And that's the Mount Lebanon's first team foul of the half. Not too bad. Limiting the fouls is the third quarter is wrapping up in about 3 minutes, and they finally get the first foul, so... And nothing but net on that free throw. So excellent form there. He gets nothing but net. And now they're only down by 20. All it takes is a couple of shots for them to fall in. They need to get some stops here. And it looks like they're slowing down Mount Lebanon's offense a little bit with the press here as Garley makes an excellent move. And wow.
Another blocking foul.
Yeah, Garley really got whacked on that one. He'll be on the line to shoot too, but still, really good attempt there. Just to try to be able to get the shot at, which he did.
That could go either way, like you said earlier. That's one that could either be a charge or a blocking foul. Rest shows a blocking foul there.
Yeah, Garley really did a good job there of like throwing the ball up like he was making a shot attempt. So smart play on him.
He misses the first there. Second one upcoming. Second one's good. The coach says to get it to the sideline. That's where Mount Lebanon wants you to go. Tommy Peters gives up baseline. Good Euro step there. A little floater. No good. Peters rebound. And Garley will retain it. Looks back to number 22. Realizes he's passed him because it's a sap. Screen for Peters. Almost going to hoist a three. Ranky drives in. No good. Rebound King. And it's good. Joey King with the little floater there. Rewarded for second chance points, doing all the dirty work tonight. That's number 15, Joey King. Sapp called for a foul there. Getting a little too antsy there. Reaching foul for Andy Sapp.
And Hoffman now, he returns from Mount Lebanon as he adds another all-around threat from Mount Lebanon. And with Altoona, you really got to watch him on both sides of the ball. You got to make sure you're not driving on him because he'll try to make the stop. And then even if you do get the shot on him, he'll surely try to be there for the rebound. Then on offense, he's just all over the court. His game's just so advanced where he can play in the paint and out to the three-point line even as well.
A couple good moves from number 11 there. Called on number 31, Andy Sapp. That's his third quick two fouls there from Andy Sapp, and it's time span to 3:30 seconds here. Andy Sapp picks up two fouls. That's his third personal.
And number 11 has really been doing a good job here for Altoona, getting his team to the line, as he's been drawing a couple fouls also, but looks like they're going to call a lane violation.
I think it was a foul called on. Yeah, I think it was a lane violation. But 22, he'll drive in.
Oh,
look for four,
risky pass.
Get there. Gartley will push off there. Gartley will search for Sapp. Sapp goes baseline, looking for Hoffman. He'll find him. Hoffman will hoist a three. And he got it. Jake Hoffman for the three-pointer. He'll hoist a three. Deep three. No good. Maybe a little push in the back there from 22 to got away with it. Back to 11 now. He'll set up the offense for Altoona here. Need to get going. They want to make a comeback here. They got to know, get a lot of steals. Speaking of steals, Tommy Peters with a great move down there. And Gartley going for the lay-in. It'll get the lay-in. Maybe and the foul. Blaine Gartley, great job going through the defender and getting the much-needed 2 points there. And Hoffman, he'll be called for the foul. Number 11, a couple good takes here in the past couple of minutes here. And that's number 11 for Altoona going back to the line for two.
Yeah, he's really been doing a good job of getting to the free throw line, really trying to get those extra opportunities for Altoona here. But going back to Gartley going in for the layup, he very nice finesse there getting that in, but looked like he was also fouled at the same time. Could have gotten an and one. Not sure. Kind of looked like he got hit in the face or the head there, but so the ref chose to play it on. But that foul that was also called on number 15, King, he is three. And he's two away from fouling out with exactly a minute to go in this quarter. So Will has to kind of watch out what he's doing now.
Missed the first three throw. Here comes the second. You got it. Nothing but net. As Altoona will go into their full court man press defense here. Mount Lebanon doing the smart move. Clear things out. Get the hands in their guard. Blaine Gartley, who then gives it up to Jake Ranke. As Mount Lebanon calls open here. Passing cut. Sapp with it. On the elbow. Gives it to Gartley. Trying to chew clock. Just 30 seconds here left in the third quarter. Maybe playing for one shot here. Playing pass and cut. Open here. As Mount Lebanon's playing hot potato here with Altoona here. As they will wait for one shot here. Get the ball in their hands to their best player, Blaine Gartley. Well, best guard, excuse me, Blaine Gartley. Hoffman, whole horse at three with about 5 seconds left, and he got it.
Wow.
Jake Hoffman with a three-pointer. Number 11, looking to climb in. He can't get that to go. Mount Lebanon with a 55-27 lead after that three-pointer from Jake Hoffman, giving the Mount Lebanon Blue Devils a commanding 55-27 lead here at the end of the third quarter.
And what an excellent shot there by Hoffman. Gets it with about 4 seconds to go, really establishing last couple seconds here, just trying to get some points on the board for Mount Lebanon. Doing an excellent job of that. And as we were talking before, his offensive game is really diverse, as he can really take it in, or he can just shoot lights out from beyond the arc. So good job by him cutting in there, increasing that lead, I should say, for Mount Lebanon, improving their chances at winning this ball game, heading into the fourth, as they are nearly up by 30 as they lead 28 and are now starting to take a little bit command of this game. Altoona did a pretty good job scoring the ball, however, though, in the third quarter, as they were able to get more opportunities at the free throw line, draw more fouls, scoring 13, so.
Mount Lebanon doing a great job taking it to the rack. Obviously, the three-point shot hasn't been working for them as they wanted to, so what do? You take it to the rack, get easy layups, get fouls called, hit down the free throws. Mount Lebanon with a commanding 28-point lead. That's the third quarter, just wraps up.
And both sides return now for the start of the fourth quarter. As it looks like, again, Levo will be have possession. And Sapp, he'll be inbounding, and we're off for the fourth quarter as Gartley, he brings it in. He brings it across half court. He's guarded tightly by number two. Hoffman, excellent scoop pass there. Yeah. They're going to call a foul. And some excellent ball movement here just to begin the game.
Great pass there from Jake Hoffman leading Joey King in.
Yeah, an excellent pass there from the beginning from Gartley as he puts some zip on that one. And Hoffman gets it, and wow, what a fadeaway by him, and nothing but net. What a great play there. That was like something that like maybe Larry Bird would do. That was just an excellent shot there. Bucket, they're showing off some physicality for Altoona. Gartley, he spins it around, finds Sapp. Here comes Hoffman. Ranke, he gets his attempt blocked. And it looks like Mount Lebanon will retain possession as the block ball there went out of bounds as it was tipped by a player from Altoona. So and now Altoona makes a sub as number four returns. And Sapp, you get a screen here from Ranky. Excellent screen. Had him wide open down there for a second, but Ranky now. He puts a move on number four. Hands it off to Hoffman. Hoffman loses his dribble there for a second, but recovers. He drives in. Kicks it over to Garley. He takes the three, and oh, that hits right off the
short.
Yeah. Hoffman, he takes that, clinks off the rim. An excellent rebound there by King as he gets the putback, but does no good. And clearly watching himself there as he tried to go for the rebound, but puts his hands up. Obviously, good awareness there, knowing that he's in foul trouble and avoiding putting himself in more and himself in more conflict, so along with the team. And Garley, he drives in, and wow, it looks like he got fouled there, and it almost bounces around there on the rim. Looked like he would have a chance at the and one, but nonetheless, he'll still be shooting two free throws. And they're going to call the foul on number five of Altoona. He gets his second personal. Hasn't been in too much tonight, but nonetheless, picking up some early fouls. And that one bounces in for Gartley. And now Altoona with a whole new look here. They have two or three guys coming in for them now. And he takes a second, nothing but net. Excellent form there. Excellent release. Gets it to go. Wow.
Nice steal. Great pass by Blaine
Gartley.
What a pass and steal for the senior number 11, Blaine Gartley.
Everything about that, 11 of Altoona tried to zip it under him, but Blaine Gartley was not having that. He got his hand right there, gets his hands on the ball, gets a steal, and immediately looks up and finds his teammate in transition and gets the nice layup there. And wow,
great
he's
steal.
All over there again.
Great steal by Blaine Gartley, picking his pocket and the
he lays it in.
Blaine Gartley, you could say he led the four straight points here from the Blue Devils. Altoona will set up their offense. Two, he'll horse the three. No good. Rebound King. Mount Lebanon looking to push it here. Ranky, he'll go baseline. And number two with a good hustle play. But Mount Lebanon will retain possession here. Incoming number 22, the sophomore, Zach D'Alessandro. Outcoming Blaine Gartley, the senior. And incoming Tommy Peters, the senior, outcoming the junior, Jake Ranky. Whole new look here from Mount Lebanon. Zach D'Alessandro and Tommy Peters. They'll try to get Hoffman on a sweep here. Altoona having none of that. Hoffman, he'll drive, and an illegal screen called on Joey King. Coach
wow.
David does not agree with that call. Neither does Mount Lebanon faithful, but
interesting call there. Obviously, really hard screen. As number two collided him doing pretty well, but King seemed to have his 2 feet down and wasn't really moving, so kind of got to question that call there by the official. And
great
wow.
block by Jared Kaufman here. He's been all over the court tonight on defense and offensive side, especially getting rebounds for the Blue Devils. Hoffman, he'll drive in. The easy lay-in. Everyone, full head of steam for Hoffman there. As Altoona will take a timeout here. Full timeout for Altoona. tiny sap for another Mount Lebanon lay, and he'll make that.
Wow.
As an injured Altoona player, number 22, looks a little banged up here.
And he hits the ground here. You gotta hope he's all right. I mean, after that rebound, looked like he made some contact with Peters there, so. To see if everything's okay with them. Okay, he has a limp, but you gotta hope he'll be all right. Showing a good sign just getting up. And hopefully he has a speedy recovery and will be able to play out the rest of his season. So, best of luck to him.
Number 22 has been all over the court tonight. He has been playing fabulous basketball, really aggressive, and just really playing his tail off.
Yeah, definitely showed a lot of physicality, and obviously on that play it looked like he got his knee dinged up a bit there as him and Pierce went at it. So clearly really been showing awesome physicality for Altoona and getting willing to make some plays and get some rebounds from that.
Mount Lebanon with the press. Altoona gets across a half court mark. 11, he'll drive in. No good on the lay-in. Tip out to number 12. Back to 4. 2's open. He'll put up a 3. No good. The foul will be called on. Looks like number 11 on Altoona. As Mount Lebanon will retain possession here. Just under 3 minutes, 50 seconds to go here in this tip-off tournament championship. D'Alessandro with the ball, gives it back to the senior Gartley. Pick coming from Peters. Good pass from Gartley. Peters could not finish there. And an ugly pass there from Altoona, number 4, tried to lead number 11, could not. Mount Lebanon retains possession here. Scartley drives in. Another good pass to Peters. Blocked by number 4. Rebounds it. Back to Gartley. He'll hoist a 3. He got it. Played. Gartley for 3.
An excellent play there by Peters. He had multiple chances to put it back in, but coach Joe David giving over some final play calling and some final plans for his team as they now head back out to the floor. Have a relatively young lineup out here tonight as they have sophomore D'Alessandro, sophomore Smith, and along with freshman Pfeffer. So
number 11, he'll drive on D'Alessandro. Drive in all the way. Good take. And good strip by D'Alessandro, but they will call a foul on the play on D'Alessandro. Number 11 will go to the line for two. Got to give credit where credit is due. Number 11 has kept playing no matter what the score is. He has kept playing hard for this Altoona team.
Yeah, and now with about 3:03 to go, so definitely within the final stages of this game, and it's Mount Lebanon is leading 70-32. Really good time for Coach David to showcase and get to see what some of his younger talent is going to do here tonight as they want to fill in. Likely going to run down the clock for the most part just to avoid running out the score, but still just to see what can get done here for the remaining parts of this game for Mount Lebanon. And subs called in here for Altoona. Mount Lebanon will have possession of the ball, and ball's in now. Alessandro, he will be setting up the offense for Mount Lebanon. As no press here by Altoona, as they seem to be putting in some of their bench pieces as well, just trying to get in, get out, and finish this game up. Smith, he circles around, goes in, drives in, gets his attempt blocked, grabs his miss though. Throws it low over the head to Pfeffer, but he gets it and puts a move, kicks it to Essebrook. Essebrook finds Alessandro. He goes in for the layup and does a good job of drawing the foul there, taking the hard hit, and he'll be going to the line to shoot too.
Great play by D'Alessandro there. Saw the opening and ran through that like a bullet, and he's going to the line. He's rewarded for going to the line for two here.
Yeah, really doing a good job of showing off his aggression there. And because of that, getting him to the free throw line, he'll be shooting two. Here comes his first, and no good. That hits what it looks like to be off the back of the rim. And now he'll be attempting a second. Takes it, and nothing but net. Excellent shot there. And now number 5 sets it up for Altoona. And Mount Lebanon really not pressing too much, as D'Alessandro is on the logo, but
straight
still on the other
here.
Half. Some good defense there by Pfeffer. Very good one-on-one on-ball defense, man-to-man there. And a little bit of a collision it looked like there, and Smith, he gets the steal. Finds D'Alessandro, and here comes Pfeffer. Slows it up, gets high catch. Finds Smith, he jabs. And good move there. Pfeffer looked like he had the three there. Goes in for the layup, showing some aggression. He gets that one to go. Nice take there. He puts Mount Lebanon up by 40 now, as it is 73-33 with about 1.5 to go now. And Altoona, they're just swinging around here. Number 12, he drives in. Kicks it to 33, and wow!
What a block.
Block party going on tonight from Mount Lebanon, as Peters just swats that one out of play. Still have possession of the ball here.
Coach David informing the Mount Lebanon team to not foul, play straight up, get this 50 seconds out of the way, and they'll be walking home as the champs of the tourney here to start out the year. 25 from the corner. He got
Ooh.
It. Number 25 comes in.
Very nice shot there from the release to get his legs into it. So Pfeffer thought about shooting that one there as he pump fakes. Finds Smith, and here comes Essebrook. He goes in for the layup, gets his attempt blocked, saves it. Great hustle there as he kicks it out to D'Alessandro. And Pfeffer,
looks like they'll hold it here.
Yeah, as he backs
out. Mount Lebanon will take care of business at home.